But now, guys, think this way. So this is a double header, so what I want to do is I want to do a quick presentation. This is going to be one of the two presentations you're going to hear today. I'm going to make it as quick as possible because I know you guys are here from the Amazon Echo. We want to see how it's working, we'll see what's going on. But I have found some fascinating things. Who am I? I'm Damian Montero. That's not what I have found. I knew that before today. You guys knew that before today. You guys see me many times. I work at Nebula. I work in the boring department, because it's a very exciting department. You guys have any of you with VR or even legacy code that you don't want to deal with? I'll deal with it. In fact, I'll show you guys some things I found while working on other customers' information and how it can help you guys. That's what we're all here for. That's what I wanted to do today. So like I said, I think I skipped ahead of class. I was blown away with some of the things you're going to see today. Some of the things you might already know. Some of the things will blow you away. And I guarantee you, every one of you, no matter how immersed you are on the web, you will be blown away. And just wait, yes, I will post my website up on the internet on a cloud server in 3 seconds. Probably in 1 minute. So what is it really that I'm doing now? I'm doing this to show you some different options because, sorry guys, Amazon sucks. Okay, that's the most explicit I can use. In other presentations you may have seen me, I hate Amazon. So what I want to do is I want to get all the benefits of Amazon without having to deal with a 15-minute setup. I'm AWS certified. It takes me 15 minutes to bury a virtual machine, not 3 seconds. There's a problem. Sometimes you want something quickly, sometimes you want a hackathon, and I'm going to show you guys an example, but I'm not really going to show you that example, about why you might want to do this when you do some mobile testing, okay? So you guys all know this, if you want to do the cloud, what is it that you guys, you probably, anybody here that's in the cloud, has to understand the cloud is, what you guys are doing is you guys are going to Amazon, to Google, to Azure, to other places, and we'll talk about some of the other places like Google, but I want to show you guys some of the things you might have not known about it. Now, trust me, a lot of them sit on Amazon or on Azure or on Google, so you do get the benefits of these masterful cloud providers with a lot of other services. All right. So, before I get into it, one caveat, an obvious one, it's free, but how? In many different ways, of course. You're going to get a little tiny bit. It's really for you to test. It's really for you to test with your friends, test somebody else. You're not going to be stopped. But at the moment you get a lot of traffic, you're going to have some sort of pain. Right? So that doesn't blow anybody up. Right? But you will be able to scale, if you see my graphic. The other thing is, it's free but it's hard. So I'm going to give you guys some Azure credits. So you want to try Azure, you want to try Amazon, you want to try Google, you want to try some of the other providers. I'm going to show you guys how to get some free credits. Okay? Just because I'm a nice guy. That's the way it is. Sometimes it's one of the situations you can't really see it, but very cute. Free, but it shows your code. In one of the examples, it is the absolute perfect presentation. Wonderful server. Everything's wonderful. They show you their code. Unless you're dead. Okay? So you can test it out, you can see what's going on, you can see it works perfectly fine. Hey, and boom, you're in the cloud in one of the AWS servers within seconds. All right, I don't know if you can see from back there. Check out the eyes and then check out the faces. Sometimes the URL is ugly. And you see what I mean by that. It's a long URL. You can't choose it. But it's a, trust me, if you're going to send out an iPhone app, an Android app, and your backend API is going to be an ugly URL, the iPhone and Android apps don't care. Your customers don't care because they don't see the ugly URL. Right? So that's how they do it. You want to pay for more? You pay, you know, you want a nice URL, you pay, right? All right. What I'm going to show you is looks, and you will say the words, yeah, but I need something serious. It is serious. It's for professionals. This is not things that are meant to goof around. When I use the word hackathon, when I say tell you it's something you can get yourself up quickly, it doesn't mean you set up quickly, and then when you're waiting for the real traffic, you go to the real servers. Now, you're probably going to be sitting on real servers. AWS server, exactly. Love that picture. Ooh, it looks like Mike over there, by the way. Mike, is that you? Looks like you over there, having a long time with it. Hey, all right. If Have you ever seen that next to an airplane? You're just, you know, I'm sure you will that day. Azure. Okay, this one's the big guys. This is what I have for you guys. You're going to write this down. At the very bottom says x.co/azure25. Go there, sign up, use a fake email if you want. $25 worth of free Azure. If any one of you guys can make a personal project that is bigger, that's a real personal project, not just your testament, that charges for more than $25, I will buy you dinner. Okay? Because I think you will have enough for that. Of course, it expires after a year. x.co/azure25. I've already featured to it. Go to meetup.com/BocaJS. In the comments, all these links are already there, as well as the site. So, you want professional, you gotta do it. Anybody heard of DigitalOcean? It's the hipsters, AWS, hipsters, cloud service. Wonderful service. Go to this link, x.co/cloud10. You'll get the first $10 for free. That's enough for two servers or one server for 2 months. You'll be able to test it out, and then I'll go, of course, go there tomorrow with a different email. You have another 2 months to set it up. You keep doing that as many months or years as you need to until you're ready. You choose. So, Frank, by the way, DigitalOcean is wonderful. If you haven't heard about it, definitely look into it. Some of you guys know about it, but I just wanted to bring it up. If you Google anything, how to do this, how to connect your Docker with your Nello and connect it on the Linux server, DigitalOcean's documentation will come up. Their documentation is spectacular. So even if you go for the documentation, it's well worth it. Heroku, everybody knows about it. You might not know that Heroku will do anything except for C#, or Sept, and Microsoft technologies. That will change in the future, but Heroku is normally the answer for most people. You guys, if you have something, if you don't have an AWS, you're calling Heroku, and of course, Heroku runs on AWS. So, you have all the information. You know, they start, you know, it's usually free. You can usually start and play around with it yourself for free, and it's only up to a bit that you can scale up, and you're probably going to pay under $60. And I've tested several sites and worked with several customers that have had fully functional traffic, but pre-detected traffic, and they have not done it for $60. Don't quote me on that. I'm pretty sure you will not try it for free. Web IDEs. You guys might have not known this. I've mentioned some of you guys this in other presentations I've done. Hey, how do you get started? How do you get started in Node? How do you get started in the backend service? These are three services available out there. Code Anywhere, Cloud9, Clothing.com. I can show you guys, but I don't really have too much time. But one of the wonderful things is I can go somewhere, like my grandma's house, log on to her iPad, her computer, and it's my environment with my settings, my IDE, all set up. Because you just log in, and the IDE, and everything is set up. Trust me, go to Code Anywhere or any of the other ones. I don't have any codes from these guys because they're free. These are the ones that have the ugly URLs. I can give you a very, very basic URL that's really, really ugly. So who cares? You can send it to your friends and say, check out this wonderful app I made. You guys will see it quick. All right. The stars of the show, in my opinion, is these two services you can hear right now. Now.com will get you up and running with either Node or Docker for free for life. Yes. Node or Docker for free for life. Yes. This is the one that shows your code. But if you're going to try something out, and you're not too worried about it, it's going to be, it should be all right. So I'm going to show you a backend. There's going to be a database in the backend. Especially if you have Docker, it's not really going to show too much. Okay? That's one of the options. They have HTTPS2, they have HTTPS, they scale up. In other words, you are hitting a server that's going to handle any traffic you want. Wow, that was a wrong color for this. Trust me, it surged like, electric. This size, that search.sh, spectacular. I will show it to you guys right here in the demo. Again, if I have enough time, I don't want to take up too much of this time to do. And I'll show you guys. Free hosting for life. Oh, it's only static pages. Wow, you guys have back-end services, serious stuff. What? You don't have CSS. You don't have JavaScript, you like the most out there. You don't have 1.5 million images, each 20 kilobytes. You like to host somewhere for free? Don't do it. They host some of the biggest websites out there for free. You want SSL to test out what's going on? No problem. We'll give you SSL for free. You want your own domain name? No problem. You guys understand what I just said? You go and buy a domain name for 99 cents at GoDaddy, and you never pay for anything else, because they will host it all. My page is up, and I'll show you that. And you can undo it all on your command line. Oh, okay. I left this until last, because I don't know if this is true. If this is true, it beats all the other ones. So don't go me on this, but cloudatcost.com. Again, it's linked on the meetups. Try. Here's the meeting. You give them one payment, one time. Right now it's $10, and it's going up. They never charge you again. That's it. Oh, what go
what's the catch?
Their service is pretty poor.
Yes.
But I bought a developer 3, which I think is like 8 virtual cores and 8 gig of RAM.
Right.
For like 90% off. It came out to like $56.
That have was you ever been charged again?
No. That was 2 years ago. So, yeah I mean, so.
Is this really?
Yeah. Yeah, $56. And every time they have 90% at the top tier, it's like the original cost is like $1,100. So for $120, I could get like 16 cores and whatever.
So something's up. Try. There's nothing to it.
But it's been 2 years and they're still going, so they're not going anywhere yet.
Right. All right. Well, that answers the question. I'm going to take out that star, because the only thing was if I did it in the first month, they didn't charge me. I'm not going to let them know they're going to be there next month, but they're there 2 years later.
No, it's been 2 years.
All right, guys. That's the, okay, so the best part about that is PayPal, right? They charge you once. If they don't charge again, they got to charge you again on PayPal, and you have to go click on a button. So you're like, sorry, don't charge me again, right? So if we're wrong, it's PayPal. It worked, monthly fees. That's what's going on. Demo time. Oh, you guys can all see that, right?
Yeah.
No problem. All right. So I have 2 sites. I do a little bit of node. Okay, here's my node. A little bit of Faker data. Anybody know what Faker is? Okay, you know, because I told you, you work. That's not fair. So Faker is a way to simulate fake information. You guys will see it right now. So I'm going to go to my command line. Here I am in Faker. My command line looks like this. I don't know, did you see it? Okay, there's a faker.js file, that's really all I need, and I need a package.json file. I'm gonna go now, I know W. Oh. Or, you know what? Boca Juniors. Heads up. He goes, yeah, I was running too fast. I'm sorry. Did I take too long? Do it again. Well, right the right green? Oh, no, it's not the right green. Oh, no. So the problem, guys? Back for it. Wow, he wants to move for me. Look at GS. Overrated balls? I do have those. Alright. It's up. Less than 30 seconds. You go to that URL.
On the left-hand side is also the server I have in their access to.
I'm not running this on a Google box. This is an actual real server, so I can go to any one of these directories. There's the directory, I can go to node this, and it'll just run node. It's running on their server, it's running on my computer, so I can be sitting on my grandmother's computer. I'm logged in, and then I can go and say, you know what, I see some files. Here's my coded ID to be able to do exactly what I'm looking for. Do you guys have any questions in 3 minutes? If not, won't do that. Thank you, guys. Guys, do me a favor. So I help run here the group, and the group has a question for you. Go ahead, and we're going to start.
Who's got a question?
No, you have to come here and present.
Okay.
So, can you guys go there right now? x.co/boca.js, we have a survey for you guys to figure out what you guys want to hear about next month. Tell me what you want, tell me what you want to hear about. Tell me if you're interested in presenting, or just what you want to hear. We'll figure out what we're presenting. Scott, I'm ready. This was your chance.